literally the worst streamer in the world. Today's live stream, Exciting Game Stream, is powered by water, the banana, and a pot of herbal tea, because you got to keep going. What am I doing today? I'm going to just play some Bloodborne. And you know what? Like, I feel like crap. I felt like crap. I'm not even sure if I've been on air for the whole time. I'm just going to start again. Hey, it's your boy Matt Lees, the world's worst YouTube streamer. I am powered by a banana and a glass of water and a pot of tea, herbal tea. I'm going to be taking it pretty easy today. I'm playing some Bloodborne. I need to play some Bloodborne so I can get to the DLC. And basically, that's what I'm doing. I feel like crap. I've had a cold for about 2.5 weeks now. It is legit getting me down. But I do need to do this, and I thought you guys could just maybe keep me vague company while I plod through Bloodborne. I should point out, though, this is not like a series. It's not a thing. It is just me playing Bloodborne. And if people watch it and go, this doesn't seem like top quality internet content that I'm used to, then it's not. It's just me playing Bloodborne. And if people go, oh man, this should be a series, then it's not. It's just me playing Bloodborne. So with that out of the way, I hate to have to caveat this stuff, but it's funny. Every time I do any kind of streaming, it always seems to bring out the most entitled people on the internet. I guess maybe because of the on-demand live aspect of it. People just want it a certain way. And you can't always have your cake and eat it. I might even actually just do this. It might contaminate it slightly, but hopefully it won't. Hopefully that won't contaminate it too badly. So, I've got to try and get this up on my thing. It's weird, like I was late today because I spilled herbal tea on my remote control, which is the most middle-class problem I've ever had. And now I'm trying to work out how to get the comments coming up on my iPad, but YouTube seems to change its API, etc. So quickly that I can't keep up at all with what's going on most of the time. Hey, I've got it. I've done it. I had to install the YouTube gaming app, and then after I installed the YouTube gaming app, it didn't want to seem to tell me how I could watch my own videos. It was like, hey, why don't I watch all these cool stream videos, League of Legends? And I'm just like, I don't want to do that. I want to watch my own stuff. Which is, I guess, actually worse, so sorry. Okay, what am I doing? Okay. Okay. So basically, I've already played a bit of this. It's not me starting a new game. I start a new game already, and started progressing through it to get to the DLC bits. And I don't know how far I got. I think I played for a few hours. I remember I managed to beat, what's-his-name first time. Guy in the graveyard. Apparently I'm level 56. Is that good? Hang on. Am I in the wrong game? Let's see. No. No, I'm legit level 56. Okay. Okay. How did I get that far? That seems crazy. Actually, I suppose it's not that far, is it? It's quite far. I've killed a bunch of things. I guess I should just do something now. I don't know what I'm doing. Let's go to Forbidden Woods. Okay. Let's see if I can get this chat window to just become the full thing. How do I do this? Bum 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 bum. No, I don't report people. Oh man, why is YouTube stuff just such garbage? Okay. Bum 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 bada bum bum bum. Let me know if there's anything wrong with the stream, by the way. I've been playing around with it, but I just got a new Elgato thing. I forgot how to play Bloodborne. Oh, No. What are the controls? Okay. This may be difficult. Hopefully the sound's okay, because I'm playing through speakers, and it might fuck it, but I can't be bothered wearing headphones. Stab, that swing, sleep. Which weapon is that? It's a gun. What does X do? Nothing. Let's roll. Sprint. That's used. Item. This is not going to go well. You know it's bad when you've legit forgotten how to, Man, I've actually got further than I thought. Who the fuck is this guy? I'm sure I've never met this guy before.
Ah, a new face, are you? And an accomplished hunter, it would appear. I am Volta, master of the League. Members of the League cleanse the streets of all the filth that spread about during the hunt. Like any half-decent hunter ought to, you know? Haven't you seen enough of these wretched beasts? Freakish slugs and mad doctors? Sentence these fiends to death with the help of your League confederates. What do you say? Why not join the League?
Sure.
Yes. As a hunter well should. Commit this to heart. Our own Carol Rune, symbol of the League.
What's going on with this guy's hair? Hang on, this might be the DLC. Have I already got to the DLC? Have I started a stream so I can get to the DLC and then...
scum and is permeated by their rotten
got to stench. The DLC immediately.
Just think, now you're all set to hunt and kill to hunt. In cooperation with your fellows.
That would be hilarious. But I should probably play a bit anyway, just because to get some levels. I don't know. I can see what's going on here. Someone wants to know what kind of herbal tea I'm drinking. It's a rooibos. Don't know if that counts as herbal tea, but it seems like it does to me. Okay. I don't even remember what the thing is. Somebody wants to know what the stream thumbnail is about. It's the clangers put into Helldivers. So, yeah. Someone asks if I got the sniffles. No, I haven't got the sniffles. I've got man flu. It's far more serious. It's potentially deadly. Okay. So, this isn't New Game Plus. Now, I remember what I did now. I started a new game and managed to kill Gascoigne, but then realized I could do it. Oh, yeah. I realized I could... I had, like, an old save from my original save, so I kind of reverted using the new game... Not New Game Plus. Using the... Sony's online save recovery thing. I basically wiped my finished save and replaced it with an earlier run-through save. But, that's up to about here. So I might not actually need to do as much thought as I thought, which is cool. Okay. Okay, let's try and get out some new messages. Game audio is high. Okay, cool. Let's go and change that. Let's go and just tweak this for a second. Okay. Bumped the game audio down quite a bit now. Still quite high, though, by the looks of it. Let's see what happens now. That might be better. I'll give that a second just so people can see. Bum, 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 bum. This guy sounds like... Da, 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 da. God, there's quite a lot of people here, aren't there? Hello. Sorry, I'm just going to try and keep up with this. This is why usually you have two people streaming, but it's just me today because I'm literally just ill and fed up and I need to do... So I can... and I'm bored of doing it on my own with a cold. It's really miserable trying to play Bloodborne when you're not feeling well. Okay. Now people say it's really quiet. Okay, fine. Jesus. Well, I've bumped up now, so I've bumped. Yeah, hopefully this will be a middle ground. Jeez, I don't know. Okay, fine, he's not the DLC. He's just added to the game. Okay, fine. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. Okay. Hopefully that's better. Let's see how I get on. People asking me why I'm streaming if I'm not feeling well. I don't know. It's kind of weird. I think because I don't really stream, so, in a way, this isn't me working. So, but again, that's why I kind of get a bit pissed off when, people are like, ah, streaming, why? When I'm already streaming, it's usually because I'm taking a day off. I don't know why, I find it quite relaxing just to play a game. It's like, you know, it's basically the equivalent of when you work at home, being able to, like, just play video games for a day but talk to people, which usually I don't have time for, but in my world, it's kind of almost like taking a day off. So I think that's why I'm kind of like warfing here. So yeah, it's like, it's weird. Most people streaming is sort of part of their job, but for me it's like a little mini holiday. And so I kind of get a bit ratty when people get expectant about things and they're like, oh. Man. That's better. Because in my mind I'm like, oh, I'm just doing this for a laugh, leave me alone. But I admit, that is weird. It is weird. It's my problem, not anyone else's. What am I doing? Alright, let's just try and become really accustomed to this. Oh, dogs. Okay. Yeah, it's super weird with streaming, I don't know why, but it's like, you kind of think, I'll do some streaming, it'll be fine, and then just most people being like, why aren't you doing it at 7 o'clock at night? It's like, because you know what, like, 7 o'clock at night, I'm done for the day, I'm like spending time with my fiancé, so, you know, that's the long and short of it. Oh shit, but actually, I think, weirdly, I seem to have lost most of those people, it's great. I don't know why, I seem to attract I don't know. All the people who were a bit demanding, I guess because I've not been very good at producing stuff on a regular basis, they've all kind of disappeared, and I couldn't be happier, to be honest. it's nice, because even it does, you know, when people are like kind of not happy about what you're doing, it doesn't stress you out, but even if you ostensibly don't really care that much, it's like, well, you know, everybody wants people to be happy. Okay. What am I doing here? Apart from, you know. Problem is now, because this is like a half save, it's like a save that's a bit done, I don't remember what I've done and what I haven't done. I think I might have already done this area. It seems a little bit devoid of stuff. Also, quite easy, maybe? Alright. I remember this bit being not a lot of fun. Hello, buddy. Yeah, that's why it's not fun, I remember now. See if I got the shortcut. It's all come back to me. People asking about pants, by the way, actually. Yeah, we are going to do that. me and Brat are both up for that, both up for doing another charity live stream day. It will be another charity thing, because if you can make some money for charity, then you should. That's kind of my attitude. But we will be doing that at some point. March, maybe not. I mean, we did it March last year. We might try and push it back to April, because my March weekends are looking pretty full at the moment. Oh, yeah. Let's get some big swing action. This is a fun game. I mean, a bit of the okay. Matt isn't ready for the DLC level-wise. That is good. Somebody says I'm in full Burns mode today. What does that mean? Oh, maybe because I'm in a scarf and a jumper. I couldn't tell if someone meant that was just being a bad mood. Why do people care that I'm wearing a, why do people care about me wearing a scarf? You guys are crazy. For whatever reason, I've really taken to wearing scarves all of the time. Because they're warm. That's the secret. That's the big secret. I know it looks really weird. It's really funny because I spend so much of my life now just indoors, on my own, that I don't really think about what I'm wearing anymore. I was talking about this with Mr. Smith yesterday. It's like when you're at a point in your life where you don't need to dress for work, and also you don't need to dress to impress or woo ladies. You just wear whatever clothes you have available to you, and that's how, of course, after years of wearing whatever clothes you have available to you, you wear the same clothes and you eventually attain that classic dad look. But what I like at the moment is wearing scarves, because they're really nice and warm on your neck. I don't really know what they look like or care what they look like. I just like wearing them because they keep my neck warm. I know that is probably the most obvious thing in the world, but I have had a few of my mates like thinking it's some sort of fashion statement. Honestly, it's just really lovely having a warm neck. It's so nice. You should try it. Scarves. And yeah, it's just really cold in my house as well. Everybody used to wear scarves when I was a video gamer, because in the winter the office got really cold. And it's kind of the same in my flat, because there's no point in the, it would be really expensive to have a heating on in my flat all of the time when it's just me here. So I just basically wear scarves and jumpers. And that's my scarf story. Whoa. Okay, right, well, I've found an enemy that's a bit more on my level. This is okay. Less than that for murder. It doesn't make any sense. Bum 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 bum. I'm enjoying something. I look like a suave house husband. You know, I basically am. Like, I quite enjoy being a house husband, to be honest. I've been endeavouring over the last year to work less. And I've been doing a pretty good job of it, frankly. But what I like to do with my time when I'm not working is cook dinner for my fiancée, so she comes home. It's really nice to see her well fed, because for a long time she didn't really want to eat food. food at all. She got so ill, so it's really nice now. I take great pleasure in just making the dinner. So, yes. Oh, fucking snakes. But it is funny watching people talk about hipsters, as if a man wearing a scarf is a hipster. It's like, if anything, unfortunately, it was showing the fact that your frame of reference for what a hipster is in 2016 is just massively, massively dated. It's like I have assholes being like, linking me to the being a dickhead's cool video and saying, oh, this is you, and it's like, yeah, but like, this isn't what a dickhead is in 2016, right? It's not even people with beards anymore, that's just massive culture as well. I don't even know what a hipster looks like in 2016, but it's certainly not me. This is what a hipster looked like fucking 10 years ago. Like, come on, right? We're all getting old. Popular culture is moving on. Where am I going? What am I doing? Is it the alien corridor? Have I been up the alien corridor? Fucking alien corridor. Big dude. No. Don't jump away. Let me kill you. Just fucking big wobbly bad ends. Yeah, I think I've been up here. Oh, yeah. It's just... fuck off. Fuck off. Whoa, okay. Ah! Really? Really? I can't believe my note is still being rated fine. I can't remember what note it was, but I've only written like one note in this game. And it gets rated fine quite a lot. Still. I mean, it was probably a damn fine note. I'm not gonna lie. But still, it's kind of... I find that amusing. I don't know, because I don't really know how the system works. I'm cycling them. Maybe it is just the fact that people who put them down the first time are the people who are still reaping the benefits. It's some sort of like broken economy. Yeah, I've already been here. Where am I going? What am I doing? If anyone's got any suggestions for where I should go, that'd be good, because I don't really know. I've forgotten the flow of the game, you know? Let's just have a tea break. Let's just have a tea break. Yeah, I saw people being like, is this going to be... the game's still a bit too loud. Okay, fine, let's slow out. I've seen people being like, is this going to be as good as Miller's live stream? Miller, obviously being Simon Miller, a video gamer. Great guy. And it's like, no, because like, that's going to be like, I guess his first time playing it, so it's going to be really intense, really exciting. This is going to be purely chilled. Like, I've played this game a lot. I know what I'm doing. It's going to be pretty easy, to be honest. But I do hope he continues. I haven't actually watched it, but I'm going to try, and I don't really have much time to watch YouTube videos, but I'm going to try and make an effort to watch Miller playing Bloodborne. Partly because he's being... I don't know if it's going to be Tom every week, or maybe it's just Jim was unwell, because I know he wasn't well this week. He was supposed to be on Dark Souls, but he had to bail. But I'm really keen to see that particularly. Miller and Jim would be great, but I don't know. I've got a real fondness for Tom Ori. He's a wonderfully funny and dry man, and I just imagine him really riling up Miller in a beautiful way. So I want to watch that. What am I doing here? Where am I going? Oh, I've forgotten everything. I've forgotten literally everything. People's asking about live streaming cooking. Oh man, nah. You know what? Like, when I'm cooking, it's a break for me. It's what I sort of learned is when I started doing cooking videos, it was fun, but it was just adding work to another element of my life, and a problem I have with my life, and it's a real fucking, this is super like fucking first world problem, so do not even treat this as being me saying it's a problem. It's not really, it really isn't. But I do end up like injecting work into almost every element of my life. And that's fine, but there comes a point where you kind of need to have something which is, you know? So I like doing cooking videos from now and then, but really what's nice about me is cooking is the only time, nice for me is cooking's the only time I kind of zone out, and I just like listen to an audiobook, or listen to podcasts, or listen to music, and just slowly chop up onions. And I just, it's one of the few times I actually just switch off, which is kind of cool. I enjoy that opportunity. So, yeah, it's interesting, as much as I want to do sort of things like that. And at some point in the future, I may end up just doing cooking. I wouldn't be surprised if I get bored of video games, I might just be like, fuck it, instead. And then maybe video games can be something I just do for fun, purely. But, yeah. I think what I'm going to do here is... I wonder if I haven't killed the, I think I might go and see if I killed the three fiery people, because I didn't discover them until really late in my playthrough originally, so maybe they're still alive in this one. It's weird trying to remember. But yeah, people talking, actually, the other difficulty with filming cooking is that it's really difficult to film and cook. It's why one of the things we're trying to do on Shut Up and Sit Down at the moment is occasionally have it so we do a review and a recipe, and it means that basically Quinn's films me cooking and then he gets dinner. So it's like, it's kind of works for both of us in a way, and we get a cookery thing for the site as well. But you can either have good food or good video. You can't have both. What do I want? Let's just go strength, I think. Or I want to just go skill. Yeah, maybe just go skill. It's not much of a difference.
Farewell, good hunt.
So, yeah, that's a thing. And actually, live streaming cooking would be really hard. I don't know how I'd do that. I'd have to like set up some little GoPro style things or something. I don't know. It's like that would be. I'd have to have a PC in the kitchen. Like that's pretty intense. Actually, one of the things I would really love is if a filming kitchen would be incredible. A kitchen with an island would be the best. Because you've no idea how difficult it is filming over your shoulder whilst you're cooking. Because it means you end up having to stand at this weird, like, 45-degree angle, so you're chopping at a really, really, really unnatural, uncomfortable position, just so you can actually see what's happening. It's not, like, a big problem, but it would be great just to be able to relax and just cook and film it without it having to be this sort of conscious concentration / physical exercise. Okay. Bum 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 bum. Somebody asking why I have streamed on YouTube instead of Twitch. To be honest, I don't like Twitch. For lots of reasons. And now YouTube has sort of fixed itself a little bit in terms of making streaming on YouTube a bit better. I thought I might as well just use it. And also it means that like afterwards I can just like leave this on the channel as like a little video if people want to watch it. As I say, it's like I don't really consider it to be content. And I hope people don't think it is. I hope that people aren't like, oh, this isn't really very good. It's like, well, it's not supposed to be. It's supposed to just be a bit. Anyway. But it means I don't have to go through the faff of downloading it from Twitch and then re-uploading it to YouTube. But I'm not terribly fond of Twitch as a platform. I'm not fond of the culture, really. It's like, you know, I'm sure it's fun to like it, but... YouTube isn't great either, but it has some real community problems. To be honest, I'm probably going to end up switching the comments off on this anyway when it's up on YouTube, because we switch everything off. It's just the way it is. Oh, come on, I dodged that. You know I did. You know I did. I didn't dodge that, though, to be fair. Oh, I didn't... Come on. Oh, I'm pressing the wrong buttons. That's why. I've just done that thing where I just immediately... to play. These guys are quite expensive. I hate these guys. That was messy. That was real messy. don't know. I don't know why Twitch bothers me. I don't like it very much. I tell you, actually, it's a little tiny bugbear, but I hate it when you get people who just come and just start using Twitch, like, terminology in other places. And just saying, like, Kappa, like it's English that anyone knows. I don't know. It just bothers me. It's like being French and walking into a bar in England and just starting to talk French and expect people to... I don't know. I guess it's, like, makes people feel like in a bit of a club, but to me it just looks a bit like... I don't know. We don't talk like that here. What are you doing? I understand it, but I still just be like, oh, really? I like English. It's a good language. You just write in words that make sense everywhere. There's something vaguely elitist about speaking in a code that you know some people won't get. I don't know. You get what I mean? I don't know. I'm probably just blabbling. Also, I've got a cold, so I'm in a bad mood. We recorded Dove Souls yesterday, and I'm really worried it was just me being a grumpy tit. Because I'm just so fed up. You know when you've been ill for like 2.5 weeks and you've gone through the initial wave of it and you just get to the point where you're just like, I am just fed up now with everything. I just want to be better. I just want to be back to normal, man. How... what's the route again to... Dude Land? Show me the way to Dude Land. I'd like to visit the... Is it here? It might be. Hello, Buddles. Oh, I haven't got a gun. That's a problem. YOLO. Okay. I need some more tea. I did say it was just going to be me chilling out. It's just chilling out, man. I might have a banana in a minute. Fuck knows. So I'm just reading what you guys are saying. That's kind of why you're here. I did say on Twitter, I wasn't joking. You're mostly here to entertain me. what a joke. This is me taking my day off with strangers. But you guys are a good bunch. That's one of the reasons, you know, you do tend to just, I don't know. You guys are a good bunch. Somebody saying, come on, play the game. What are you waiting for? Hello, Nioman Saputra. You obviously have just stumbled into this, maybe via YouTube. This is the problem with streaming. This is the problem with streaming. People turn up and they expect streaming. Hello, pig. Would you like a sword up your arse? You're not gonna get one, unfortunately. We're not substantial. No, just finishing off the old fashioned way. Okay, I'll take that. No. No, buddy. No. A few people having an understanding of a. of needing to have the line between work and your own time. Well, this means I've either done it or I've never been here. I think the former is probably more likely, to be honest. Okay, let's do this. No. I don't know that guy's patterns. Well, this is a problem. I've only done this boss once before, and I did it way too late in the game, and it means it was actually, like, a real walk in the park. And it means I don't know it, you know? You've got to struggle if you want to know something. Come on, then. Okay, that's the main problem, isn't it? This is the real problem. Sloppy. Stamina. This is not great, is it? Could be worse though. Oh no. No. I've now reached the point where if I don't do this, I'm going to be kind of annoyed because I've been hit for too long, you know? I'm trying to solve my starters. Close. Bad. Okay, that's good. I remembered one thing about that boss fight. You want to kill them quickly in succession. Because otherwise, I think a big snake comes, unless I made that up. I might have made that up. But it doesn't seem unlikely, does it? A big snake? You know? I'm just throwing that out there. I'm not saying, like, you know, Bloodborne is unimaginative, but... Snakes, big snake. Let's have a big snake. To be fair, those guys are pretty cool. The thing I like about that boss fight, actually, is the fact that you've got, like, the three enemies. It's really cool to... Oh, yeah, okay. Bergenworth time, I remember now. The thing I like about that... Oh, get off me! That's enough! That's more than enough, mate. Jesus. Okay, yeah, I found the point where I'm supposed to be level-wise. The thing I like about that boss fight is that you've got three enemies. And you've got the enemy, which is like the caster doing the fireballs. And then you've got the enemy really coming at you with a sword. And then you've got the kind of middle guy who breathes fire, who's trouble, right? But you instinctively either deal with the guy who's coming right at you, or you go and deal out the go and deal with the caster, and you kite the two guys, and then you run around and you kill the caster. But what's clever about that boss fight is you've got this middle guy, the guy who's like kind of got a sword, but he's also got some casting. But in a way, because he's not a direct threat or the most solitary, you kind of ignore him, and you end up either focusing on the guy who is up in your grill or the guy who is easy to pick off on his own. And then the big twist, of course, is the guy who is in the middle, the guy who you damage the least, probably. The guy who you deal with being not a threat the most is the guy who gets the fucking flaming sword and actually becomes a big problem. And that's just smart. It's cool little design of being like forcing you to just go, oh no, it's that guy, he's just... It's cool. Anyway, I'm going to eat a banana now. So if you just tuned in, you're expecting to watch the stream and you're wanting to play, then you're going to be like disappointed. But, you know, whatever. A few people asking about Sponge Squad, i.e. me playing more XCOM 2. In a series, that will happen. That will happen. I'm probably going to wait a little while. Let the patches come in, because there's still a few, like, you know, little bugs and stuff. And I mean, the first XCOM was full of bugs as well, but... Let the game get sorted out a little bit. Also, let modders just remove stuff so I can skip through lots of the boring... Because after a while, it's like, you don't want to watch the dropships coming in again and again. So once it's been modded a bit and once it's been patched a bit, I'm definitely going to get on that. A few people asking if it would be me and Quinn's playing it. It won't be. Because to be honest, like, we're having fun doing the Invisible Ink thing, but after a while, even he's getting a bit bored of me just being good at Invisible Ink while he sits next to me. For XCOM, you're talking about like 20, 30 hours maybe of like videos. The first series was maybe like, I don't know, it was big. So it will just be me, I think. And I know that's not as much fun as having two people there, but at the same time, first of all, like, Quinn's like bounced off XCOM 2 a little bit. He didn't like it as much as I did, which is, you know, fine. Sometimes people get a bit weird about that. They're like, oh no, but one of you likes the game and the other one doesn't. It's like, that happens all the time. Like, I don't really like get on with Darkest Dungeon, but he didn't play it. It's fine. People are individuals, and that's fine. So there's basically a bunch of reasons why that's not going to be happening like that, but it's fine. It'll just be me very quietly murmuring to myself. It'll be similar to Sponge Squad, the first series, I guess, which was fun. I had a lot of fun making that series. But I will do that, just not yet. Also, like, XCOM 2 is still quite fresh. I want to make sure people actually know it a little bit first. And I need to know it a little bit more as well. Otherwise, there's no way I'm going to be able to manage. I thought there was a guy up here. Oh, no, there's a guy up here. Oh, I hate this guy. I hate these guys. These are guys actually that really freak me out. Look at them. Oh, they really scare me. For those of you who watched my Bloodborne Diaries series, which is me just playing for the first time on this, yeah, you'll know that. Oh, come on. Oh, come on! Yeah. Let's see if I can just roll a thick away from here. That worked. Come on, dude. Right, screw it. Keep it safe. Play it safe. Okay. I was worried I was gonna need one more hit then, and I was like, you're out of stamina. If you need one more hit, you may be in trouble. Arcane Lake. One of my least favorite lakes. Why has it just gotta be so different, eh? Why has it gotta be so complex? Okay.
I can't go into Bergenworth just yet, I don't think. Yeah. I have to first go round the other side. And there's a whole bunch of nastiness to be found and had. Such a pretty place there, Bergenworth. I mean, it's horrible as well, but... So... Right, let's try and make a mad dash for it. I hate those big things, and I hate the bugs. I hate everything. Oh, come on. It's fine. Everything's fine. Let's just get a sleeper. Okay. Everything's fine.
Is there anything in here? I can't remember. It really bothers me that there's like... something like in here that I don't know how to open. Maybe it's a DLC thing, actually.
But there's always this. This really pissed me off. This is the one mystery I couldn't work out. I never worked out how to open this. Really annoyed me. Because everything else in the game, I kind of rinsed this game, really, in terms of coming back and looking at places, because I was determined to kind of, like, get a sense of all the mysteries and stuff.
You fucking... I forgot about... I didn't know you came down here!
I hate fighting this guy. Because, actually dangerous. Oh, I might run away here. Yeah, I'm gonna run away. Because I'm gonna die. That was me. Really, legit getting scared there. It didn't make a noise. I knew the hunter was upstairs, but I forgot that if he can see you as he's walking down the stairs, then he comes down. It's funny how people are saying, like, oh, my elite strategy for Bloodborne is to turn the volume down. Sound design is terrifying in this game. It's way easier when you can't hear the monsters coming. In a way, yeah, it's actually like when you turn all the sound, especially music off for the boss fights, it is easier. But it feels like cheating. It feels like you're, like, switching off game mechanics. And to turn off the music... and to make the music go away, and make it means the game is not intense. And really, beating the boss battles is always easy, providing you don't let yourself get stressed out. But getting stressed out is half the fun. So I feel like it's complicated. In my way, in my mind, I feel like you are cheating because you are cheating the game's design. That the game is designed to stress you out, and the audio is a relatively important part of that. So although it's not actually going to come up and say, oh, you know, achievements disabled, you've turned the sound off. Obviously, you know, you can just turn it off on your TV, but. At the same time, it feels like you're breaking the design. So that's just my hot take. Anyway, talking of hot takes, I'm gonna hot take a piss and finish my banana. So probably at the same time, it's fine. I remember what I'm supposed to be doing. I've just remembered. Hypogean jail. Hypogean, hypogaina. Don't know how it said, but where's the lady gone? Lady, where are you? Are you in the garden? Perhaps. Maybe not. I can't remember all the places she can be. If you haven't seen my Bloodborne Diaries series, actually, you should definitely check it out. Just because I basically condensed my first playthrough of this game down into
little bite-sized chunks, so it ends up like turning about maybe 50 hours of play into, oh, there you are, you were kneeling down. Well, about 50 hours of play into about 3.5 hours of video. But it was a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun with it. And the reason I'm doing this is to try and get up to the DLC so I can make some more. Make some Bloodborne Diaries about the DLC. I don't know if it will be like a weekly series again. It might just be that I like blitz through the whole DLC and then just make maybe one special or something, like a long video. Just because, yeah, even though there's a bunch of little mini series stuff I want to do, I'm sort of aware that if I... we're already doing Invisible Ink. If I started doing Bloodborne Diaries again as well, and if I started... And then, like, at some point doing XCOM 2 as well, it suddenly starts to veer towards having, like, too many series-based things to do, and not having enough time in the week to actually, like, play other games and make other videos. Although at the moment, this kind of suits me quite well, because... I think partially because I've got a cold and partially because I've come off the back of the double whammy of playing Dragon's Dogma and XCOM 2. I'm just not feeling a lot of stuff. I've been trying lots of different games and new games and I'm just not feeling it at the moment. And because I can't be bothered making videos about games, which are me saying, this game's okay, or me making videos saying this game is bad. I mean, if I play a super popular AAA game that everyone's raving about and I think it's bad, I might make a video about that just as a counterpoint, but... You know, kicking a game that's not very popular or not really known about and saying this game's not good. That doesn't... What's the point in that? Like, if you never heard of it, then who cares? So, I try and just, on Cool Ghosts, just make things that are positive. Not just to be, like, you know, shilly or, like, ah, happy, happy. But just... Otherwise, what's the point in kicking something no one's heard of? You might as well get excited about something that not someone's that no one's ever heard about. But if nothing's making you exciting, and if nothing's making you excited, then what do? You know, it's kind of tricky. You can't force that. So... Yeah, this is what I was doing. I was in the jail. Because in my first playthrough of this, I didn't come to the jail enough, often enough, and I missed my chance to do... Well, actually, you know, I didn't miss anything, but it felt like I'd missed something. And this area is different as well, actually, before. When you come here out in the game, there's like a weird fucking skeleton thing there. Or like a burnt thing. Oh, yeah, there's a pig. I remember there's a pig. Pig, 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 piggy. Lay a piggy egg for me. That's weird. Don't know where that came from. Come on, piggy. Oh, no. Alright. That's fine. Done. Oh, the music in this area, man. It's fucking brutal. Okay, looks like we need a mod in the stream. Let's go and make somebody a mod. Who wants to be a mod? Who wants to be a mod? Let's make Eric a mod, because he's here and it's his birthday. Actually, that's kind of cruel, isn't it? But you don't have to do it if you don't want to. I feel bad now. I know that you can do it, but... Let's see if this works. Why isn't that working? How does that work? Add moderator. And I apologize to everybody else in the stream, but unfortunately, yeah, sometimes this is why you can't put things on the internet. This is why you can't have comments, because you have to be responsible for the platforms that you host, and you have to be responsible for the people on them. So, yeah. Who else is about who can do it? That's what. And happy birthday again, Eric. Happy birthday. Mm-hmm. 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 Sorry, we've got to just do this and sort this out while I drink some tea. To answer your question, though, Eric, I am excited about Bravely Second next week, even though, really, I've heard it is just more of the same. But I played the demo, and I talked about it a little bit on Dark Souls yesterday. Oh, God, I still do that. It's ridiculous. And, yeah, it's good. It's a good, fun thing. How do I do this? Okay, well. That's somebody blocked. Cool. Bam, bam, bam. Bam, 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 bam. Bada, bam, 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 bam. Bada, bam, bam, bam. Bada, bam, bam, bam. Oh, yeah, I am literally just humming. I am literally just humming Take That now. Jesus. It's fine. This is why there are always people who are assholes. It's fine. And it will be fixed. It will be fixed in a minute, honestly. Like, this just requires me being some, just doing a little bit of admin, of just checking people who want to actually do it and adding people. Thank you, Evans. I thought I recognized that name. He's a good man. And I'm going to add some of the Shut Up and Sit Down mods, because the Shut Up and Sit Down mods are possibly some of the best humans on the planet. Bam, 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 bam. We shouldn't have much need in it. Like, I purposefully try not to be too popular these days because it requires less moderation. I've lost a lot of fans over the years, and I can't say I miss any of them. Okay, cool. That should be fine for now. I don't think we've got major problems here, but that should be fine. I think you guys know what you're doing. It shouldn't require much moderation, but if it does explode, feel free to let me know and I'll add more. So, yeah. Dun 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 dun. Somebody commenting on Twitter saying, "You sound like an entirely different person." It's like, yeah, I do. I've just really got a cold. It's gonna go soon though, I'm sure. It's one of those things where it's just lingering in my chest and my throat, and it's just, it will fuck off. It will. Can I go through here yet? No, closed. I like that, open gate, closed. It's like, yo, I know it's closed, but, yeah. Maybe there's nothing I can do here yet either. Hey, it's Paige from Beyond Good and Evil. How are you doing? I like the pigs with many eyes, but they're a way off, I think. So I'm just squinting at the screen here. Yeah, you know, I think I've done everything here. Oh, what am I doing? I can't remember what I'm doing. There must be something I'm doing. Is there somewhere I can go that I haven't been yet? In here? It's really surreal, like, going back to being, like, playing in a kind of earlier version of one of your saves. Just trying to remember exactly what you were up to at that point. I feel like I've lost a lot of direction. Okay, yeah, that doesn't work. That comes down from somewhere else. And that was the point when the first time I did that, I was like, oh my god, I'm here! I'm here again! This is cool! Obviously, I'm not getting that reaction this time because I've done this. Where am I going? I feel like I'm just a crap tour guide of Yharnam. Here we have. Actually, no, we've gone the wrong way. We'll just go back to the Hunter's Dream for a minute. If everybody can just go back to the dream. Bum 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 bum. Okay. Dark Beast Pal. That's a good question. Until Rom is dead. Yeah, I think Dark Beast Pal. Yeah, it must be because Dark Beast Pal's thing is already on my list, isn't it? Places graveyard the dark. Because actually, graveyard means dead. Just in case you didn't know that. So I've already been taken to the prison. So yeah, it's Rom, I think. I think it's just Rom. Yeah, that's the bit, isn't it? Okay. I don't like Rom. But I've got to do it, I suppose. Thank you very much to Vertical Games for that heads up. See, it's useful having you here. If I was just playing this on my own, I probably would have wandered off and done something else about half an hour ago. Just not knowing what I'm doing. Okay. Okay. Oh, that's not fair. I was coughing. Come on. That's really not fair. Come on. Bloodborne, don't do this to me. Don't get a man when he's coughing, alright? That's just cruel. Okay. Well, I might as well clear this area down here. Just because. Whoa! Okay, right. I'm gonna think about how I gotta fight this guy. Okay. Sedatives. I'm gonna do some of them. Right. I don't even remember what this guy does. I don't think he's that bad. I think he's just terrifying. Yeah, it's like gaping dragon sort of design. Again, though, this is a wonderful, wonderful piece of monster design. Because it's like twinkly and you can't make out what it is from afar, but you know it's firing fireballs at you. And so you're just like, I don't know what the fuck that is, but I need to get close to it. Because obviously it's firing massive things at me. You think it's basically a cannon, and you think, what do you do with a cannon? You charge it because it's firing long range big projectiles, easy to dodge. And if you're up right close, it's not gonna be able to hit you. So you sprint at it, right? And then you don't know what it is. And then you get close and you're hitting the front of it, and you realize you're face to face with a wall of fucking teeth. And that is just, again, it's just a really clever, like, it's not even enemy design, really. It's like encounter design in the same way that fight against the three dudes is just good encounter design. It's just the first. It's kind of a one-trick pony, but the first time it catches you, it's like properly like, ah, what the fuck? It's really cool. Bloodborne's a really good game. It's a really, really good game. Like, I think maybe a lot of people haven't bothered with it because they just look at it and go, oh, it's just more Souls stuff, and it isn't. It does borrow a lot from Souls, but I think it's really smart, interesting design. I think it does a lot of its own stuff, and and I do not want to be here. Categorically. Jesus. I think that's what makes this fight actually quite hard, is the fact that you... is that you've got no really good area to fight in. Oh, no. Good. What? One of those things hit me. It's ridiculous. I mean, you could fight him downstairs, I suppose, but... Also, the fact that the problem with this guy, though, is you... He starts upstairs, you want to kite him away because then you can fight him in a bigger area, but as soon as you get your distance from this guy, he becomes way nastier. And just starts casting spells, which is just ruining. Oh, come on, don't get sloppy now. I mean, this whole fight is going to be sloppy. Don't get so sloppy that you die. Okay, fine. I say this guy, it's a woman. I'm an idiot. I do wonder where idiots pop up from on live streams, though. If they're just cruising YouTube, or if they're just people waiting. I did have one guy who spent a, it was like a bank holiday weekend, and he spent, like... It looked like it took him a while. It was like an hour or something. On a bank holiday Monday. You know, it's probably a day off work for somebody. Just going through all of the really, really old YouTube videos I have, which still had comments enabled, because I thought they were far back that nobody cared. Oh. Old Hunter Mensis. Is that bad? Oh, good. I can't lock on, so it's good. Hello. Is this... Okay. Cool. Hey, Damien. How you doing? I guess we're going to see the old man. Oh, no, I need to go up to the thing first. I remember. Get the key. Get the key. Save the world. But yeah, he just went through and pasted the same comment. It's like horrible comment on all of them. It's like, and the funny thing was, it took me like, I just had to click one button just to get rid of all of it. And it's like, man, you just spent an hour doing that. Like, it's just really sad. It's just sad, as Josh would say. It's just like, why? Okay, all right, you belly bastard. Again, a lady, not a man. Although you can call a woman a bastard, that's fine. In fact, I prefer you did. I'm not keen on gendered insults. That's pure Dark Souls, that though. You run up the stairs and go, a chest! Just enough to just distract you from the fact there's an enemy behind you. I'm actually pretty excited about Dark Souls 3 now. Not excited, but I was super cynical about it initially. But having read some people who I trust, and some people I don't, but I've read some thoughts from people who I really do trust, and I think maybe it's going to be alright, or be good even. So I'm looking forward to giving that a go. And I'll probably try and do the Diary series format for that as well. Although, unlike with Dark Souls 2, if I'm really not feeling it, I might just abandon it. Because I really did persevere with Dark Souls 2, and I just wasn't enjoying it for such a long time. Like, in the end, though, there were some great things, but a lot of the time it's, yeah. But for a long time, it was a bad thing. Disappointment. Is that you, Log? Is Log in the stream? Is that disappointment? Is that a different disappointment? Mikalash Cage. That sounds like a Log joke as well, so hey. Okay. God, I'm tired. Just checking that the stream is okay. Are you going to the DLC blind? Did you know a fair amount about it? I know nothing about the DLC in this. I never read about these things. Like, I didn't actually know anything about Bloodborne when I started playing it, really. I just seen a couple of screenshots. I try and avoid that as much as possible. To be honest, when I used to work for OXM many years ago, I used to have to write lots of previews, and it's kind of ruined, because you know loads about the games before they come out, and it sort of spoils it in a way. Especially if you know something's going to be good. It's just like, I prefer to just stay away from it.
Okay. Hey, buddies. How you doing? Pretty bad. Okay, but you've given me some insights, i.e. scary stuff. Is this guy gonna come? Oh, no, don't tell me he's just gonna stay here. What is the point in having this guy? What? Who is this guy? Why is he here? Have I got a special ring on or something? Have I just... No, you don't really have rings in this, do you? That's Dark Souls. Because I'm like, now, like, I don't really want to go into this boss fight on my... Like, I don't want to go back and get my souls, because if I'm going to lose this guy, he might be useful in the boss fight. But it looks like he's not going to come in the boss fight. I've never seen this before. I've never had an old hunter appear, but hey. Somebody asking why I left Video Gamer. God, that was a long time ago now. It was like 2 years? More than that? 2.5 years? I've already covered that loads of other places. I can't bother talking about it. It's complicated, but it mainly comes down to the fact that I want to do more work with Shopee today, and then we can work out how to make it work. But, it was good for everyone. It was good for everyone. It meant that Jim got my job, and he's brilliant. And yeah, it's just one of these things. It's actually really good in the long run, because they've now got their own little niche, I've got my own little niche, and everybody's friendly, and it's fine. Hey Ron, why you gotta be so vacuous, man? Okay, that guy is here, cool. And he's casting spider magic. That's fun. Hey, that's a good timing. I didn't really need it then, but I'll have it. This fight used to freak me out so much. Whoa, I don't like seeing that happen. Even though I know he's on my side, it just freaks me out. Thing that can make this easier. I'll chuck a Molotov cocktail in. Cheekies. I knew that wasn't going to do anything good, but hey, you've got to have fun. You've got to treat yourself, you know? Ugh, hoping to get one more hit on there. Oh, what a feeling when you're walking on a lake. Now is the point where it starts getting a bit interesting, isn't it? Because the sky becomes dangerous. Dangerous. Okay, right. Whoa, okay, fine. That's actually a pretty good window, I think. Something that is starting to do some damage. Whoa, that's bad. Okay, fine. That's unfortunate. That's unfortunate. I do wonder if I've got some lightning paper. Yeah, I do, I've got quite a bit. Okay, cool. I wonder how what set up my gear is looking like. No, I would get to this. I've sort of just done the same thing about 4 times. I plus 6. Maybe I can upgrade it a bit more. I'll see how I get on. I probably don't need to, but hey, you know, every little helps. That was the old ancient moniker of Bergenworth. Also, fuck bugs. Fuck you, buddy. Oh no, I've run out of fucking... What's that? Oh, that's... No. Are you still chasing me? Really? What have I done? Okay, so I can just bring that guy in, but it might mean bringing in more people. Fine, whatever. I'll have him. I'll take it! And actually, before I get into this, I'm going to have a little wee. A little pre-ROM wee. Right, let's see if they get on with this. What time is it? It is 12:30. Should probably stop in about half an hour and make some lunch. I think I might bake a fennel. YOLO! I say that, it's just because I've got one. It's not like I'm just going to go out and get one. Fennel's a weird one. Never know what to do with it. But, you know, you get by. Okay, you rommy bastard. Okay, should I even bother killing the spiders or not? I can't remember what the best strategy is with this. No blue guy this time. Maybe he timed out. That's a shame. Oh no! There he is. Talk about late to the party. What took you so long? Old hunter? Damien? I'm sure this stuff wasn't in the game originally. Is this one of the things they've done to make it a bit easier? Like, just have it so you can, like, just have a dude come in. And was it better? Oh, hang on. Something to do, haven't I? Okay, cool. Let that charge up, and then go for full. That's not bad. Could be better. Could be worse. Right. People talking about fennel in the chat now. It's kind of like a mild aniseed sort of thing. Whoa. That was... I say it was lucky, but I think it was just well-timed. I think it was brilliant. Definitely not. Okay, let's just ignore... Oh, God. What? You're joking? Oh, come on. No. Some really good fennel chat in there. Really good fennel chat. It's good with fish. I've probably said that already, but it's good with fish. Question is now, can I be bothered beating my head against this guy, or should I just go and level up a tiny bit? Probably not. I could probably just do this. Am I being chased by the bug? Is question number two. No. Good. Come on, Damien. Let's have a party. Me and you. For those of you tuning in and going, oh girl, you're doing streaming again, this is pretty one-off, I've got to say. Like, I'm usually pretty busy with other stuff. I'm just not feeling up to doing any work today, so I thought I'd just try and get through Bloodborne, level up a bit so I can actually start playing the DLC and make some videos about that. But as it's a game I've already played before, I figured I might as well. I keep forgetting to get my echoes back. Man, I'm a real nub at this game all again. Oh, I forgot to put a thing on. Okay, fine. Oh man, no, this is a bad shout. Bad shout. They jump on your head, don't they? You know what, actually, weird, Rom swinging me around there was really helpful. Oh, just leave me alone, alright? Oh, I'm going to need to grind because I'm pretty much out of little potions now. Oh, you... Yeah, no, I've really screwed this up. Maybe I just go big, go home.
probably go home. Well done, dames. Yeah, I'm not wasting more wallpaper here. Look how many. This is a... I'm just going to take it. Actually, that's a really bad idea. Purely on a health management basis. It's a terrible, terrible tip. Oh, my God. Oh, this is like Gav Murphy's nightmare. Oh, I forgot you do that, don't you? Spider. Dead. Yeah, people pointing out Damien isn't really helping that much. And now I've got no vials. So. Okay. Back to the dream. Who I got. I always forget about these things. And then every now and then I'm like, it's either like really good or unbelievably pointless. Like, well, why did I think that would be helpful? Especially if you've forgotten to use them for ages. Like, sometimes it's like, use them at the end of the game. You're like, that's genuinely worthless. Like, that's just nothing. That's not exactly a big total, but let's see what I can do in terms of upgrading my weapon. Just to make this fight a bit easier for me. No, I can't. Okay, I need three big chunks. Only got one. Not really hit the point where that's a thing. Like gems, though, if possible. I've got going on with that. Oh! Yeah, right. amazing how they got all these stats and details, but all it is, well, when I do it anyway, it's just literally just spinning down and going, does anything go up to, do the numbers go up? Yeah, the numbers go up, cool. So that's that. Okay. Bit more damage, fine. I think I can buy some blood vials from here. It's quite expensive though. That's fine. Okay. Okay. Saying I should upgrade my tonitrus. Maybe I'll do that. Maybe I'll do that. I've never really used it. Right, where am I going to go and farm to get some stuff for that? Yeah. I think this is a good place for it. Yeah, I'm up for upgrading the tonsures, actually, just because I've never really used it. I got it, like, way too late in the first time I played this, so it'd be nice to just go and have a play with it, really, if nothing else. God, it's getting cold in this room now. I'm just gonna shut the door, actually. Oh, hang on, this isn't the Witch's Abode I was thinking of. Well, I'll go for a wander anyway, see what happens. Maybe it is the one I was thinking of. Oh, it's not here, that's for sure. A lot of people saying, you shouldn't be streaming, mate, you sound really ill. Honestly, I've been this ill for like 3 weeks. I've been continuing to work through it. I've been making loads of, you know, doing a lot of shop sit down videos, more stuff than that, and cool ghosts, to be honest, at the moment. The podcasting still, it's fine. It's fine. And this is not really work. I know this is what I meant, yeah. This is what I want to be. I'm not really working here. This is me just having a laugh. This is me occasionally saying things. I'd just be talking to myself, to be honest, otherwise. Bastard. Just... whatever, dude. Yeah, it's good for blood vials as well. And I need blood vials, really. Could have been better. Killed, aren't I? Yeah. You know when you just know? You just know. You're like, well, I should really start dodging now rather than just hammering attack because you're going to die. But you just do it anyway because you hope that you might just mysteriously just manage to knock them off balance and then kill them and save yourself. But pure laziness. Pure laziness. Laziness that kills. Lots of people saying congratulations. What's that about? Oh! Somebody called Kirsten, who's just had their PhD paper approved, I think. Their first scientific paper been published. Kirsten Finley. Congratulations, Kirsten. That's great news. That's genuinely very impressive. Have a good day. Which way am I going? This way. Sorry, I'm just getting distracted by reading the feed. Bam, bam, bam. Killing women. Witches. They are awful. All the single ladies, indeed. Okay, where's that? I'm sure there's another one. Where's she gone? Maybe there wasn't. How much these guys move. They really do move a lot. Blood vial action as well. Oh, that's an impressive little fucking... Oh, no. You see, these guys do that quite a lot. It's really annoying. Like, you do catch them off balance, and yet... And yet they hit you, and... Oh, screw it. Just screw it. It's good for blood vials, though. It's good for blood vials. Oh no, it's turbo lasses. Forgot about these guys. God bless infinite stamina, let me. Fucking swing it. How much you need to start ton-tristing it up. Really? Can't remember how much it costs to level up weapons. Hey, cool. Someone's just dropped in to say they're really enjoying Cool Guys. Thank you very much, man. Mr. Sick. Thank you very much. I'm enjoying doing it. A lot of fun, but I'm just really at the moment looking forward to just not having a fucking chest cold so I can do it with my energy for real rather than just persevere through and just get stuff done. Especially it was annoying because I was trying to get more stuff done because I'm away for like 8 days in March, so it's probably gonna be a bit of downtime on the site, to be honest. We'll still do Dark Souls, but yeah, apart from that, it's going to just be, like, nothing going on, because we're going to be at GDC for a week doing, running the lovely board game lounge at GDC, which is great fun, because we basically just have an area where people who are game designers can come and have a little go on board games. Just actually, you know, we talked about this on the podcast, about how game designers should be more au fait with board games, because it's really interesting design ideas and stuff, etc., etc., because we actually get to implement that. We actually get to sit and be like, hey, play these games, look at these games, understand these mechanics, think about that. So we actually get to literally preach what we preach, but directly to the people who really need to hear it. And also we just get to spend time chatting to people, interesting people, meeting devs. I find it really interesting just getting to listen to some devs doing talks about game design. I always find it fires me up and gets me kind of interested in that sort of stuff and sparks off interesting conversations that lead to new videos and ideas and stuff. So it's going to be great, but it's basically going to be like 8 days of no videos getting made. I mean, I have toyed with the idea of going out and trying to do videos when I'm out there, but it's just, I don't know. It's like we're there to kind of do something else. So it ends up, if you're trying to do two different jobs, it just gets a bit stressful. And it's actually really nice just to kind of just relax a little bit and just listen to really interesting people who know what they're on about talking about games. Just to refresh my own references and make sure I do know what I'm on about. So I kind of enjoy it as being like, obviously a lot of what I do in my job is talking, talking to people and letting people know what I think about stuff. I think that's only really valuable if you ensure that every now and then you really take the time when it matters to actually just shut up and listen. And GDC for me, that is great. I think I could go and do lots of videos at GDC, but really it's not like, well, in a place like GDC, I have like the least interesting things to say in many regards. Like there are so many amazing people saying really interesting things. I prefer at that point to just almost take the time to just listen, learn stuff that I can then condense and think about and then talk about at a later time. And turn into something entertaining for you guys or interesting. There's nothing more wonderful than just being able to sit in a room full of really, really clever people who know more about stuff than you do and just to listen. It's just the best. I always love listening to people talking about things when they're experts. Even if it's something I'm not really interested in, there's nothing better than just listening to people talking about stuff that you don't know about. But at a level which is clearly like, these people, this person knows this stuff. Like, they really, really know it. Okay, that's pretty decent. CED. Okay. Doesn't look like it does a lot of damage though, but hey. Let's give it a go. What we got? What we got? I don't think that improves lightning. Not yet, no. Let's take these ones off, actually. I can always put them back on again. You know, my biggest concern now is I'm going to be really rubbish at using this because I've never used it. Do I want the blunt plus 90 though? That might be, no, that's only going up to 92. But that one takes it up to 101, but knocks down. I don't even know. That one doesn't have any effects. So okay, fine. Why the glum face, Mr. Man? Oh, why do you use a potion? You're an idiot. Okay. Pressing buttons I'm not supposed
Welcome
to press.
Welcome home, good hunter.
Sorry, I just got text.
What is it you desire?
Got a message from Quinns, who's editing. We recorded me and Quinns
recorded a head-to-head Let's Play of Catacombs, a new edition, the other day, which is a flicking-based skill game. I don't know if it'll be on the site today, because I think it's a ton of footage, and I think it was taking hours and hours just to even get the footage onto this computer off the SD cards, but that'll be up on the site at some point. And yeah, that was a lot of fun. But he was just texting me about what he's doing in the edit, and it sounds like a lot of fun. He is a good dude.
Welcome. What is it? Very well, let me...
That's the difference between me streaming when I'm working and when I'm not. Just stop to go to read text or whatever I want to. Okay. It's not equipped. Equipping it is a good start. Oh, look at that. It's a zappy zappy. Okay. What's going on with this then? Is that just a charge button? Is that like, I have to charge it? I guess so. Bang. Is this guy gonna follow me now? Oh, that was lucky. He got a lucky jump there. There's nothing worse than that kind of cheesing. There really isn't. Just stamina cheesing of just going, can I keep doing this? Can I just keep hitting you? So this just looks like it's free paper in a way. Like, just boosts your bolt. You know what? I'm gonna have this guy anyway, just cause why not? Sky and the cosmos are one. Don't I know it? Oh no, I fell in the water. Oh man, first time I jumped off that. That's scary. Okay. Just got a bit of a bug hunt, shall I? Oh no, you. Wow. Okay, cool. Yeah, that's real cool actually. Can I do it through the faces? Kinda can. I mean, not as effectively, but miles. That's nice. Oh yeah, come on. I properly. This is great. It's like I got a cattle prod. It really is. Like. Oh, don't hurt me. Alright? Just let me hurt you. Deal? Smash your face in. Okay. Oh, that was badly timed stamina, but
actually, that was still pretty good. That was, in fact, that was really good. Okay, cool. What's that? Sure, just got madness knowledge. Yes. Did not know you could do that. I did not know you could do that. That's cool. Bye bye, Spideys. That is so much easier with a big Bosher. And I got to play with the big Bosher. Which is nice. Oh yeah, God, this bit. Jesus fucking Christ on a bicycle. This is the moment where this game just... I still get chills just thinking about this. This just... When this happened, it was just like, what the fuck? What the fuck? And it never really gets resolved. Well, it doesn't, you know? Like, you know, as with any of these games, it's lore to pick apart and think about. But first time I saw this cutscene, it was just like... What am I even playing? Some great questions in the feed from Claire saying, how do you know if someone is secretly a spider? I mean, I've been thinking that for a long time. It's just a great question. There's no answer, is there? Let's be honest. Okay. Secret ritual's broken. Seek the nightmare. Newborn. Obviously. Bum, bum, bum. Go downstairs. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. You aren't ready for this, etc. Where's the thing? I just thought it was here. No, it's further down, isn't it? I remember now. Is this a trap? Sort of. This game, it's always like, is this a trap? The answer is either yes, no, or sort of. But mainly just yes. Or sort of. Okay. Hunter's Dream. I'm going to go and have some lunch, but I will come back and do a bit more streaming in about an hour, just so you know. But for now, I'm gonna go and eat some lunch. So yeah, thank you for joining me while I play some Bloodborne. I'll continue playing some Bloodborne a little bit after I've eaten some fennel. I think I might bake it with some parmesan and some breadcrumbs, because otherwise it's just fucking fennel, isn't it? You know what I mean? Anyway, for all of this chat and more, I'll see you in about an hour. Thank you for watching, if you've been watching. Goodbye.